Fading and crossfading are very common effects which create attention marks and tell the viewers that a scene is ending. It is very useful to add these effects already inside your animation tool and not in the editing process at a later point in time. How does fading in OpenToonz work? Technically, fading and crossfading is increasing or decreasing the transparency level of one or several images. In OpenToonz, it is an effect applied to a certain frame sequence. I have prepared two examples for you. The first example is a fade out of a scene into the black, the second one fade in from the black. Let's start with fading out into the black. Here's a scene from my current animation project. Let's assume for a minute that you want to fade out this scene. Add a black image to the canvas and make sure it's on the first hierarchy of all images. In OpenToonz, you have to place it to the last unused column of the X sheet. Cover the entire canvas with this image. That's complete darkness. Open the stage schematics and switch to the Effects tab. Add a transparency effect to the black image. The effect is controlled by keyframes. Add a full transparency to the first keyframe of the black image so the image is invisible. Add another keyframe to the frame where the fading should start and set it to 100%. The fade-out shall take 3 seconds. Since my preferences are set to the standard of 24 frames per second, let's count 3 times 24 equals 72 frames from the last keyframe. Here you set another keyframe. This time the transparency is 0%. When now you play the animation, you don't see any fade out. Like all effects in OpenToonz, the fading effect is only visible in the preview mode. If you have a fast computer, you may see it in real time when you click on the preview button. In any way, the full effect is applied in the rendering process. This is how it looks after rendering. Now let's fade in. You have probably guessed that you only need to change the order of the parameters, and you're right. The effect is applied from frame to frame. This is how it looks after rendering. Thank you for watching this video, and keep going.